Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stealwing 33 Plays Enter the Gungeon. I'm Stealwing 33, and today we have a sound opportunity, my friends. My friends. Today we have the opportunity to potentially finish killing all the pasts. Now, that's a good step forward, you know? I'm nervous, because obviously this is like, it's not like super crazy that we're about to kill the last past, but you know, it's a big step forward, because then I know that there's a challenge that takes place after we kill all the pasts. There's one more type of thing to do, and then we also need to beat the old king, the one inside of the church of the true bullet, of the true gun, or whatever the hell that is called, the second secret floor. Those are the last two things that we have left on our agenda for the game after we kill this past, so I'm hopeful. I'm feeling pretty good. I know I can beat the game as the hunter. The hunter is one of the characters that I'm actually like fairly decent with. Had a little trouble hitting that bulletkin with the crossbow bolts because I'm stupid, but whoop. Oh, come on, aim better. There you go. Alright, well, let's go ahead and grab this HP since I already got hit. But I'm feeling confident. I'm feeling good. I actually just finished beating Final Fantasy VII. That's what I was doing right before the recording. And I'm kind of happy with it. I've never actually beaten a Final Fantasy game before, so I'm happy to have 7 ticked off the list. They're legendary games. It did not hold up well. But luckily, it not holding up well meant that I knew how to abuse the game a little bit. Like, you know, a lot of modern games don't allow you to, like, you know, grind in the same spot and use, you know, certain tactics. Like, there was stuff that I just did that, like, apparently was, like, very advanced tactically speaking. For instance, I did a lot of pairing up my, like, added effect materia and my add element materia with, like, stuff that caused status effects, like, you know, paralyze and sleep, to, like, a character that did an all, like, strikes everybody attack. Which, you know, isn't, like, super crazy advanced, but apparently for 7 it was, because it's, I was reading a tutorial, like, a wiki guide to make sure, like, I wanted to have, like, the party that I decided on, which was Barrett, Vincent, and Cloud. I wanted to make sure that they were all decked out with, like, you know, their ultimate gear and stuff, which some of that stuff you can miss if you don't, like, know where it is at the point in the game that you're at. In particular, like, it's super easy to not get Cid's ultimate weapon, because, you know, the game doesn't tell you where any of that stuff is, and, you know, it's pretty easy to mess that up. Alright, Master of Unlocking off the first floor, off the first chest on the first floor with still rooms left to go. It's actually really good. That bodes well for the remainder of this run, especially since we are playing as the Hunter, who I do have a good track record with. She is the character that I normally get the furthest with, even before I started beating the game pretty consistently. And having Master of Unlocking is going to just make that even easier to do, because it will increase the number of keys that we're going to end up with over time here. And I'm pretty pleased. I'm pretty pleased right now. But we'll be good to go. Good to go. All right. Let's check out the shop. There is a key on the shop, and there's also Priscilla on the shop. Priscilla's selling the heart purse for curse. Let's buy the heart purse for curse. I don't mind. And then we'll just pretty much hope that we get more money, but I'm not too worried about key economy now because we have Master of Unlocking, so whatever. I'm feeling pretty good, actually. We're already sitting pretty with, like, one of the better items in the game at our disposal, and if we just keep playing well like we have been, we'll be doing fine. Now the only thing I want is a better boss fighting gun than the crossbow. The crossbow's not bad, but I would prefer not to fight bosses with the crossbow if we can avoid it. Not for any particular reason other than it's just a little slow. Does good damage. It's a good weapon. It's just a little slow. I don't like using very slow weapons against bosses. I prefer rapid fire weapons against bosses, and slower weapons against, you know, rooms and stuff like that, because it's better that way. And that's just me. I mean, it's I'm willing to sit down and say that that's not, you know, consistent with, like, what might be the optimal way to play the game. But, you know, that's on me. Little Bomber, although very slow, it is an explosive weapon, which makes it slightly better versus bosses. I haven't fought Gatling Gull in a fucking King's Age here, man. Welcome back, Gatling Gull. Welcome back. I hope I can still remember how to fight you properly. Appears I do. Alright, there we go. Gatling Gull, not the hardest boss on this floor, by and large. Yeah, the crossbow is slightly faster than Little Bomber, but Little Bomber being, again, being explosive, is its advantage there. Because basically what that means is that we can destroy enemy bullets using the explosion effect, which, you know, I can't understate how important that is, or I can't overstate how important that is. I can understate it all I want. It's garbage that's understating it. It's really good. Explosive weapons are consistently one of the better weapon types in the game. The Little Bomber's biggest drawback being that it is slow as shit. It does good damage, though. I'll say that much. And it's got, like, a really weird charge time, because it doesn't have a good sound cue for when it's done charging. Which, you know, that's on me. Like, I'm a little impatient, and I like to try to min-max my weapon attacks, but that doesn't work too well with the, with Little Bomber. But we got mastery, so whatever, we're fine. I kind of want the machine pistol, to be honest, but we can't afford it, so I will buy a key instead. And we will be on our way. Goodbye, everybody. See you in therapy. But we'll be good to go here. Good to go. All right, down to the next floor. Good to go. Gungeon proper. Floor 2. Hopefully we can keep up this run of form here. So far, I'm not super thrilled with the weapon choices that we've been given. But we'll see. I mean, the run's got potential still, and it's not like, you know, not like I'm terribly concerned about whether or not we're going to win. Not at this point, anyway. I mean, we'll see. Once we get into, like, floor 4 is really when the metric starts to happen. That's when I'll know whether or not, like, we're in a good shape. It is possible that we might get down to floor 4 and just, like, get completely destroyed because of, like, bad damage and, you know, if we fight Amoconda on this floor, there's a high chance that we'll end up getting killed. Just because Amoconda's my Everest, apparently. But crossbow, still very solid starting weapon. I think out of all the weapons that I have used, this is one of my favorite ones that we get basically for free. Because it basically turns into that as a jammed bat. Glad it's a jammed bat. We'll just hide over here and avoid the damage. Gotta be careful. The curse is probably gonna come back to bite us at some point. But we more have to be careful because if we take 2 more curse, then we'll start getting jammed bosses. And I don't like my odds of being able to win any run with a bunch of jammed bosses hanging over my head. I normally try to get hit. I normally get hit like once or twice. The further into the game I go, the more often I get hit by bosses. By floor 4, I'm getting hit at least 2 times a boss fight. Which, that would almost kill me in certain situations. Even right now, if I get hit twice right now, that would put me at critical... It would cut my health in half. Which is pretty scary. So, we'll hope that... We'll try to not do that, because I don't know if I can deal with that very easily. Alright, come down here, pull the guy this way, blow him up. Hide around the corner. I think we're doing alright. I think a big thing that changed, like, my ability to win or lose is using corners to my advantage. Figuring out that you can shoot around corners was a big boon for me. That is 2 curse. We cannot take any more cursed items, which is kind of a shame, because I would like to be able to take more cursed items if we could manage it, but, you know, we're not going to be able to, so no use crying over spilt milk here. The sword shield, actually probably not something I should have taken. The item's not bad. It is a defensive item, technically speaking, because it does block bullets. It's not worth the curse, because the shield only blocks one... It's kind of like Leaf Shield from Mega Man. It only blocks round per part of the shield, which means it can only block a maximum of, like, I think it's like 10 or 15 bullets. But then, like, as you block bullets, it becomes less and less consistent with its blocking. Like, you have to actively do it. That's kind of like trying to use a Gwan Stone to protect yourself. It's just not going to work super well. It'll work, but most of the time it's happening on accident, not because you're, you know, making it happen. But we also have, you know, an impossibly large amount of keys, so I'm not going to super sweat it. Probably should be checking these for mimics. We actually haven't fought a mimic in a long time. Like, in a long time. But, you know, it's fun. Aha! Our first jammed bulletkin. Our first jammed enemy that actually matters, rather. Is a better way to put that. Flip the table, please. Thank you. The light gun's not bad. I think out of all the guns we have right now, this is probably going to end up being the one that we end up using the most. Just because, like, it is a little bit more consistent, and it does pretty decent damage. The duck especially doing semi-decent damage. The trash cannon isn't bad, but the problem with the trash cannon is that it is inconsistent on a good day. You know, let alone, like, now, where, like, I can kind of make it work on rooms like this, but because I have to hit a wall first for it to be, like, particularly good, that does diminish the usefulness of it. I should save a little bomber for the boss fight, actually. Which, you know, is fine. We'll use the trash cannon on, like, the rooms or something. Which is when they're going to be the most useful, because, like, we'll be able to make the garbage bullets hit the walls and poison people. Which will be nice. Like, right there. Like, that's... This is how the trash cannon does damage. If we can get junk, we can make the trash cannon better. Because it does increase in damage the more junk you're holding, which is nice. But that's okay. Ruby bracelet... I think Ruby Bracelet protects us from fire, or it's dodge roll up. I don't remember. We don't really need to worry about using our money for keys, so I am free to buy stuff, which is nice. But I'm going to explore the rest of the floor. I don't want there to be like a pop-pop statue or something, and then I blew all my money on a fucking Ruby Bracelet that does something that I'm not 100% familiar with. Like, that would be embarrassing. Like, I got 57. That's enough for... at least 3 stacks of pop-pop, you know, if I was on a bad day. Well, on any day, because it's consistent, but, you know, whatever. Fight me. That's what I'm going to say. You know, the nice part about having lots of jammed enemies is that I should have fallen into the pit. I don't know why I didn't. The nice part about having lots of jammed enemies is jammed enemies have a tendency to drop more loot, so they, like, you know, they'll drop health, and they'll drop, you know, items and money more consistently. You know what, actually, let's buy the amulets. So the amulets do kindle more bullets per floor, but you have to have them and then go down a floor. So the sooner we buy one, the better. And since we don't really have to worry about having keys because of Master of Unlocking, I actually feel comfortable spending some of our hard-earned kashish on that. I am still going to wait to see if there's, like, a pop-pop statue or something more valuable on the floor. Like, maybe, you know, if there's, like, the carnival game, maybe we'll do that instead. But the key economy is too good. We have so many keys that I'd actually be willing to trade some of them away to Keyman in order to buy items. Like, that we're sitting kind of pretty right now. Do I want to buy the lodestone amulet? So, the lodestone one increases the damage that our blanks do to enemies when I use it, but the frost one freezes people. I think I wanna get the one that freezes people, right? Like, that seems prudent. So we'll do the boss fight, and we'll see if we end up with enough money to do that. It is fucking Gorgon, and it's not Amokanda, which means that we actually have a chance to get mastery on this floor, oddly enough. She is immune to poison. So the trash cannon's worthless against her. In fact, it might actually just make my life easier, or harder, because it causes poison to pop up in places where I'm not expecting it to. Which is weird. Let's go ahead and just blank there. I didn't feel like trying to navigate my way out of that one. Just go ahead and dodge a little bit here. There we go. Alright, there we go. Oh, we had a blank there because I was going to get hit if I didn't. Which does mean we are out of blanks now, which is not an enviable position to be in relation to the Gorgon. You know, little boomer still doing pretty decent damage. The 3D. Damn it, we got hit. It's hard for me to, when we're, like, above the target like this, it's hard for me to tell where the bullets are going. Because they are two-dimensional objects moving on, like, a three-dimensional plane up towards my player character. Because there's, like, a 2.5D faux realism going on with the pixel sprites. Which is fine, but, like, it does make it more difficult for me to tell. It's only on the diagonals. On any straightaway, that's fine. But when something's traveling at me diagonally, I have a little bit of trouble seeing it properly. So, shame on me. I got hit, but whatever. It doesn't really matter. Got the camera. Not bad. And we did get enough for the frost ammo lit, so let's go buy that. And then we'll head down on the next floor, I guess. I kind of probably should have gone down to, what's it called? The Oubliette. Because we had, I think we had enough keys leaving the first floor to go down to the Oubliette without, what am I doing? Just teleport. Without having to worry about it. But, you know, I can respect that. I can respect both trains of thought on that one. But, you know, we'll see. Alright, there we go. Down to the Black Powder Mines. I'm feeling pretty good. We are going to use the camera to clear rooms, because you guys have heard my spiel about the camera being one of the best guns in the game for clearing rooms. It has its ups and its downs. I do wish it did more damage, but, you know, whatever. Would I trade my health away to an avenging statue? This becomes a question that I now must contemplate. Probably, actually. If for no other reason than I think it would just be, I think it'd just be prudent. Get the trash cannon. Fire the trash cannon. These guys are immune to poison, I just remembered, so, you know, that was foolish. That's alright. They are not immune to being exploded to death, so, wow. Get your shit together, Andre. If you're wondering how I aim, by the way, like if, like, you know, you're sitting there marveling at the fact that I can shoot enemies, I aim slightly behind them. Most of the time, it's easier to aim at a target that you're not directly aiming at, but if you're aiming slightly past them, you're more likely to hit them. I don't know if that holds true for actual firearms, but in video games, that's the way that I always do it. Seems to work out pretty okay. Jesus H fucking Christ. The light gun... it's proven to be the only weapon we have right now, which actually startles me slightly, because I think I've pissed on the light gun on episodes before, but now we're sort of, like, riding it, because it's the only weapon we have that does, like, consistent damage. Everything else is sort of, like, it's kind of junky. Except for a little boomer, obviously. And the crossbow's alright, but crossbow's not ideal for this situation right now. Mostly because it doesn't one-shot things anymore, and its low ammo count is completely based on the fact that it has early level uses. It's also, like, super bad against bubble bop dragons. But the camera's not, so we will use that instead. Right, let's get out of this room here. Real quick here. We're doing alright. I need to go back and get ammo. I need to get that ammo really bad. It appears as though the Ratman has been scared away by my presence, so we just won't leave this. We won't leave this place here. We'll just stay right here in this corner and keep Ratman away from our ammo, which I just remembered he does steal. I'm not sure how I feel about this, to be honest. Sorry, I need it for the light gun. There we go. Yeah, we had to do that whole risky business because I needed ammo for the light gun, which is a gun, again, that's a mimic. Let's just kill the mimic here. There we go. Oh, what is that, flash grenade? You know what, it's the chaff grenade. It causes people to get stunned. We only have three of them, apparently. Problem is that I can't pick up the, the knife shield anymore. Because we'll get a third stack of curse, and that'll cause us to have a bad time here. Chaff grenade, pretty good. I've read about this item. Basically, it stuns everybody on the room when you use it. And I think you get another chaff grenade every now and then. I think it either has a cooldown or you get more chaff grenades every time it cools down. I don't remember which one it is. I keep trying to hit spacebar to fire the knife shield. That's why I used the chaff grenade there. Oh my god, hit the fucking phoenix bird. There you go. Oh my god, shoot the thing. There you go. See, this is what I'm talking about. So, like, whenever I'm shooting that stuff diagonally like this, if it's downward, that's totally fine. But if it's upward, my brain goes to shit, and I can't, like, figure out where to aim at them from. Is that finally a goddamn key to stop goddamn Helmet Man from being trapped? Because I hope so. All right, there we go. There appears to be an NPC over here as well. All right. Let's check it out. Map Man. Free items. Hell yeah. Let's do this. Sure. Let's check this out. Can I take these? Nope, can't take them. Alright. Yeah, I mean, it's going fine. But, you know, we'll be fine. We'll be fine. Woo! Ow. Take this! Alright. At least the crossbow still shoot one-shots Red Bird Man. I'm taking a lot of damage on this floor, to be honest. Like, too much damage. This is sort of what I mean. Like, we were doing fine on the first two floors. It's when you get down to, like, floor three, floor four, that you can really start telling. I mean, we're still fine, because we still have, like, 3 HP, and frankly, we're doing fine. But, like, I need better weapons. The sooner I get a gun that I can work with, the sooner we'll be good to go here. That's alright. We're just gonna keep using a camera, I guess. As it is literally the most consistent weapon we have. embarrassingly so. Because I need to save the rest of our little bomber for the boss fight, because it's the only gun we have that is good in the boss fight. With maybe the exception of the light gun, but then, like, the little boomer's only got 8 shells left, so, like, I need to keep that and keep it ready to go. Flash rays, not something I would consider pretty good right now. We'll leave. We'll see what we get on the rest of the floor. We might come back for the ammo, if things don't change. But, you know, we'll see. There's the boss fight. Let's go here. And go down here. So hold on 1 second. Sorry about that. I dropped my phone on the ground. I really should just get in the habit of putting this on my bed, but you know how it is. You know how it be, baby. It doesn't happen very often, but sometimes I do have my phone on my lap and it falls off while I'm doing stuff. Take a picture. Take the picture. I do wish we had just like literally anything better than the camera to work with right now. I'll be honest, I'm not super thrilled about using the camera, like, for every single room. It does work, don't get me wrong, it just takes too many freaking bullets to, like, do that work. It just needs to do more damage. Don't get me wrong, hitting everything on a room is good, but I need it to be better. Because if it isn't better, then we're gonna have problems, right? Alright, cool. Alright, we're doing fine. We'll take out the trash cannon for now. Trash cannon, again, it's not good against, like, Cannon Balrog. It is good against, what's it called? Fucking douchey Treadnought. There we go. douchey treadnought, but it's not very good. Not very good against. Well, it's worthless against goddamn cannonball rug. Well, we're trapped. Till the fucking goo goes away. There you go. All right. Hopefully we get something good out of this chest. It's a brown chest. Already not feeling good about this. Yeah, it's a key and a super soaker. Oh, that's awful. What up, dude? Okay, see you later. Let's go talk to Map Man. Hopefully Map Man will give us something usable here. Yeah, share the map. There you go. And we got the Gungeon Pepper. What the hell's the Gungeon Pepper? I've never seen this item before. Deals damage to nearby enemies. Huh. Interesting. So it's we have like an AoE burn field on right now. Are we really going to buy the flash ray? Is that what we're going to do with our life right now? No, we're definitely going to buy ammo for the fucking little bomber, though. Yeah, fuck it. We'll just go down to the boss fight. I wanted the chaff grenades. If we get Treadnought, the chaff grenades are going to be useful because we'll be able to use it to stun the adds that spawn, which will be nice. We're still alright. Ooh, no, I got hit. Alright, fine. We're still alright, though. I mean, even not getting mastery on Treadnought's still going to be fine. We are down to our last chaff grenade. I have decided I do not like this item, for the record. I've also decided that Little Boomer is not a fun item to have to lean on for boss fights, because it is slow. And it stops doing, like, fantastic damage against the bosses. On, like, the third floor. Oh, wait, no, this isn't the fourth floor. This is the third floor. I thought we were on the fourth floor, because I always... I remember Treadnought being much harder than he is now, because now he got nerfed, at some point. I don't remember when, but he did get nerfed at some point, and now he's a lot easier, but, I always associate him with the fourth floor, because I always felt like he should have been a fourth floor boss. I guess we'll just use the Mega Dowser. It's doing pretty consistent damage here, I guess. I wish that thing did, like, a blank. Like, each one of these stupid things did a blank. I wish my camera stunned people. I wish we had better weaponry. What else can I complain about right now? That'll make me feel edgy. Nothing. We're taking a beating right now. I'm not doing super well against Treadnought. And I blame 100% the slew of weapons that I'm working with. Hopefully that changes next floor, because otherwise this is not shaping up well. We need some kind of passive, or we need to get something like we need to get like a good weapon, something more consistent than what we're working with here. When the light gun's the best weapon you have, it's not good. Frozen Heart actually, it's not bad. I'm not going to complain about that. It makes up for the fact that we got hammered on Treadnought a little bit, which, you know, it's nice. But it's fine. Come on, work. Computer, come on. Move your mouse. There we go. Come on. There we go. All right, there we go. Got it. We're good. I explained about that. Sometimes I lose control of my mouse when I have my gamepad plugged in while I'm playing Gungeon. It only happens when I change floors, which, you know, I'm not sure why that happens when I change floors. I'm imagining it has something to do with, like, the control scheme for the game getting reset every floor or something like that. Like, it, like, registers my gamepad because it's, like, always plugged in and the game, like, wants to default to that or something. I don't know. I'm sure there's an explanation. I'm not a programmer, though, so I'm not too sure what that explanation might be. The trash cannon is a terrible weapon. It's seriously kind of awful. It subsists entirely based on the fact that, like, it can poison targets, but when you can't poison a target, suddenly it turns into one of the worst guns in the game. From my perspective, it's slow, inconsistent, and it does terrible damage. So, I mean, you know, there's that to work with. Shit. Alright, well, there was no way out of that one for me, I guess. There's just a long way to the top if you want to rock and roll. I'm not gonna lie, the idea of using the Mega Dowser for more than, like, every now and then appalls and horrifies me. But it's rapidly looking like that's gonna become the way of the world here. If I can't get something a little bit better than the Mega Dowser, I'm probably gonna die, to be honest. We're running out of ammo on all of the other guns, and a lot of them aren't... they don't stack up well the later into the game we get. Which, you know, it's fine. I can try to skill my way out of it, I guess, but... We're not sitting very pretty right now. Doctor, give me the news. I've got a bad case of exploding you. You know, and I don't revel the idea of trying to use my sidearm either, but my sidearm's actually better than some of the guns we have right now. You know, the Mega Dowser is a beam weapon, but it's a, like, very pushy beam weapon, so it's not, like... You know, there are good beam weapons and then there are bad ones. This is not one of the good ones, to say the least. Not only does it not do very good damage, but... You know, pushy beam weapons are not high on my list of guns that I enjoy using. You know, and I can't... I need to save weaponry for the boss fights. So, like, we have to live with the idea that, like, we might at some point have to buy a weapon from the shop. If not, there's a weapon good enough to buy. Is it homing bullets? Oh, homing bullets are really good. Alright, we're gonna try to save up for homing bullets then, because that might make... that'll make a couple of our guns significantly better. In particular, the little boomer will be better. The little boomer's already pretty good, but it won't be made better by the sheer fact that we will be able to consistently home with it. There we go. We'll get the lead knight to kill what's his douche for us, the Iceman, Ice Block Man, Ice Swamp, Ice Thwomp, I trash cannon ammo. I thought I was on the fucking goddamn light gun. I must have rolled the mouse once too much. That's infuriating. Because I really need light gun ammo, and I really don't need trash gun ammo. Trash gun is trash. I guess we're just gonna have to hope that we don't end up getting too fucked by this. Don't kill Hero Bulletkin Man. Alright, no, we're good. Just stay away from the Bulletkin. It's fine. The one with the cape on, that's the one I'm talking about, if you are wondering what it is that I am talking about. Okay, easy does it. Just be cool, man. Really need to get rid of this jammed Skele-Man here. Oh, stay away from me, please. No! Mr. Bulletkin, I'm sorry. The duck got you. The chili pepper did damage to him. I forgot that I have the ability to hurt people passively by standing near them. I do not want to use that as an active effect, but if we end up using nothing more than our what's it called for the rest of time, the sidearm. There we go. I mean, I can do stuff like this, I guess. Just tie it around a corner and just kill them from around the corner with the chili pepper. Oh, that's actually fantastic. That actually was pretty dope, I'm not gonna lie. Ow. Get out of here. I mean, that does mean that I don't have to use ammo on, like, the bitey guys. The bitey guys do not... If I can kill them passively without having to shoot a bullet at them, I'm gonna... Basically, is what I'm trying to get at here. Oh my god, get away from me! Get away! There we go. Alright. I'm not gonna lie, chili pepper is a fantastic item. I think that is a gag at Hot Pepper Gaming, by the way. It's a YouTube channel where they make people eat really hot peppers and then play, like, do a game review of some caliber. They're pretty funny, actually, if you're interested in watching some good YouTube content that isn't my own, obviously. Not that any, like, no, I... Hot Pepper Gaming is not, like, an unknown channel. I'm not, like, showing you, you know, like, Northern Lion or something where... Oh, the hammer. Blessed be. Blessings to the hammer, for he has come to save the day. let's go get homing bullets real quick here. Homing bullets plus hammer, super great. Ooh, need it. Need three more money. Well, hopefully we can get that before the boss fight. I don't foresee a situation where we wouldn't get that before the boss fight. Unless we get incredibly, incredibly unlucky. That would not be something... Like, if that happened, I would be not only surprised, but, like, I'd have to make a subreddit post about it, because that would be hilarious. Just keep dealing Hot Pepper Gaming to them. Get away from me, please. Alright. Bring out the hammer a little bit. Bring the hammer down. Get away from me! Please! Alright, we're fine. Nah, we good. We Gucci. Oh! I fell in the pit. That was dumb. Well, I mean, I guess the Heart of Ice is gonna do some damage now. We got a key and we got ammo. What do we want ammo for? We'll take it for the crossbow. My reasoning being that I think the crossbow is actually, like, a weapon I could feasibly use without, like, getting super messed up by these guys. If nothing else, it's at least consistent, which is good. We'll just kill this last guy by running around in circles. There you go. Alright, dead as hell. Cheap how cheap. Cheap as hell. Alright, let's go buy homing bullets before I forget. Because the longer we don't have homing bullets, the less time I have with homing bullets, which, you know, I'm not on about. Homing bullets, very good with the particulator. In particular, is pretty good with the homing bullets. Particulator in particular, haha. Get it, because it sounds like particle. But it also make me miss less, which is nice. What do we need ammo for? Let's grab ammo for the camera, because it's out, and I actually do kind of like the camera. Ooh, red chest. Red mimic? Dog boy? Nope, we're good. Duct tape. Duct tape. It's the hammer plus the super soaker, then? I don't think I like that. Camera plus light gun? I don't think I like that either. Let's see if I can figure out how to change the order that I pick up these weapons in. No. Let's do... Okay, wait. Let's look at the order of our guns. So, it's basically going to be light gun plus hammer, hammer plus squirt gun. Squirt gun plus camera, camera plus that. Shoo! Okay, so whatever I drop last gets comboed with whatever's before it, right? So let's drop the hammer and pick it back up. Okay, now this is the last gun, the first gun in our inventory, which will get comboed with the light gun now. So let's try to do Hammer plus super soaker might be good. Hammer plus camera might be pretty good. Yeah, let's drop the hammer here. And we'll pick it back up. Hammer plus camera. Let's do that. Alright. Right? That worked? No? What did I combine it with? The crossbow. Hammer crossbow. Alright, not what a combo that I would have done, but... Whatever, it's fine. At least we still have the hammer. I didn't screw up that badly. There was a high possibility that, like, me doing all those shenanigans was going to cause us to lose the hammer, and I'd have been pissed. Ooh, before I forget, let's, where's the squirt gun? Nope. Hammer plus squirt gun actually would have been okay, as well, but, I didn't like the odds of us actually being able to, hit people with the hammer if we had the squirt gun going all over the place. Yes, I am searching for secret rooms here. because I'm getting a little desperate. I need some health. Is kind of something I would be super into right now. I know that they're normally attached to. Yeah, I was like, they're normally attached to special rooms, right? Which, you know, I'm actually kind of glad we came into the shop and we did blow a blank, but it did pay off with two hearts, so I'm not gonna come sit here. I'm not gonna complain. What are we gonna? We're gonna be fighting High Priest, Kale Pillars. Also acceptably difficult, to say the least. I wonder if these count as jammed shots. That's a good question, actually. Should look into that. Now, Kale Pillars are a boss fight that I do... I think they're one of the only fourth floor boss fights that I can get mastery on. That I'm actually, like, feeling fairly confident in my ability to get mastery on. The hammer, obviously not an ideal weapon for this kind of boss fight. Normally something with piercing would be what I'd be using. But beggars can't be choosers in this situation, so we're using the best gun that we have available to us. Is essentially how I'm gonna look at this right now. Ow. Well, okay, there goes our mastery. There goes our second hit, I guess. The hammer is out of bullets. How come it is out of bullets so quickly? I don't remember firing too many bullets while we were on the floor here. Killed another one. We're getting close. We're gonna live. I'm pretty confident in our ability to live here. I'm not super confident in how the fucking high dragon and the fucking forge are gonna go, but we'll see. Oh, that was bad. That was really bad. Okay, little boomer is the one I want right now, because it is the strongest single shotgun that we have at our disposal at the moment. And it'll make this boss fight really easy, because we kill half of the bullets when we fire it. Which is, you know, good. Got it. Alright, we're good. We did it. That was scary. That was really scary. We got a little bit of health back, and we got frost rounds. Ugh. Hell yeah. Alright, let's go back to the shop real quick. There is ammo here, but I can't afford it. I just realized. Alright. Looks like, Alright. I'm a little nervous, honestly. I'm a little nervous. 4 or 5. Alright, what do we got? We need to get hammer bullets. Hammer rounds are our top priority right now. To say the least, they are a top priority. We will use the camera to attack people from safety for as long as we can. And we'll use the hot pepper to kill them passively when we can. And we hopefully will be fine. Hopefully we can make this happen a little bit and... I don't know, maybe we'll pull off a miracle. Get out of here. Shaman Man, stop summoning Skelemans. I kept firing there, and it wouldn't do it for some reason. It's quite upsetting. Fire the camera! What the fuck? Take a picture. Alright, there we go. We're fine. Oh, that's bad. This is really bad. Oh, this is not ideal. It's like, please go away. Frost rounds plus bomb. Actually super good. So Little Boomer is an explosive-type weapon, and explosive-type weapons synergize ridiculously well with, you know, any passive ever. Yes, we'll use a blank. Yes, we'll open this. What the hell is that? Galactic Medal of Valor? That is an item we unlocked for killing the pilot's past. What the hell does it do? significantly increased damage dealt to powerful foes. all right. I think that gives us extra boss damage. I had to guess. That's quite the get. I'm gonna be honest. I'm pretty pleased about that. We're just gonna hide over here, and we'll wait for this douchebag to show up and fight us on our terms. We got our blank back. We're using it on the blank statue. I'm feeling okay right now. A little nervous, obviously. We got a frost bird, apparently. Frost ducks. It's a frozen duck. You know what? Whenever it wants to go off, it just... You do you, man. I wonder what'll happen with the Super Soaker, then. Because, like, ice stuff is normally synergistic with water stuff, right? I think I took damage there. We need hammer bullets. Where's the hammer? There it is. I really hope we don't die. I'll be mad. We gotta play cautiously, I think is the way that we're gonna have to do this. Oh, I understand why it's not firing. Sometimes we're a little too close to the wall, and I can't fire if I'm too close to the wall. Alright, there we go. I really need health. This is gonna get dicey. I need to find the blacksmith, like, ASAP. Because if we can find the blacksmith, there's a chance I can buy health. Oh, this room. Oh, nope, there it goes. Alright, fuck. Well, the streak is broken. We'll have to try again with the hunter on the next video. That sucked. We didn't get any weaponry. Look at this. Look at these weapons. These are the garb. We got so many good passives, though. Ah, so mad. All right. That's going to do it for this episode. So thank you all so much for watching. If you like what you saw, let me know. If you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date on when I post more videos. And if you really like what you saw, leave a like. It helps the channel grow. Helps me out a great deal. And of course, with that, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!